So good afternoon everyone, myself G. Sivakrishna, I am the faculty of St. Martin Engineering College in IT department. Today I am going to discuss the topic is machine learning. So what is the machine learning and what are the concepts of machine learning? Nowadays new technologies are added to learning the programming. So by using this machine learning and languages. Now what is the machine learning? So machine learning is nothing but all of you know that. So we have to perform some programs as a human rational device. Suppose how the human will be thinking, those thinking rationality thinking about given to the machines. So means we are learning some given programming. We are giving some programming to our data. Explicitly we are giving the programming. For this programming giving some experience that we learn, what is it, machine. This learning on this particular programming we call as a machine learning concepts. So by using machine learning concept, how it is done, this particular learning programming concept, how it is. Suppose machine learning nothing but it is a run on some experience programming, means whatever the existing programming that will be improve the experience of the programming to specific task and measure the some performance. So what is the learning is? The learning is nothing but machine learning nothing but they have to rationality of programming to learn and update that particular machine by using some experience with particular task, and this task will be performed some measure. So by using this measure we can take on particular task, class of task on this particular performance measure on the task, whatever the task we are calculating the programming, whatever the task on the performance measure to improve this programming knowledge. To improve this programming knowledge is called as a machine learning concept. What is that? Machine learning concept is nothing but we are improving some programming on specific task. This task will be measured on performance measure tree depending on particular task. And will takes that particular task will be takes performance, then only it can improve our experience. Means to whatever the program we write, it will use to understand the programming and more to experience on the particular programming. It will perform some task, then it will more effectively run these particular algorithms. So basically it is defined as two types of two types of learning methods. Those are supervised learning . Second one is unsupervised learning . Supervised and unsupervised learning. So what is supervised and what is unsupervised means? Before we starting the supervised learning, I will give some examples on the particular way of supervised and unsupervised. The name itself is given to the whatever the learning algorithms we have to following on the particular experience, particular task to measure the performance, that will be defined and by the categorical wise or some training data we are giving. Suppose I am giving the programming input and I am expecting output also. I am giving to following the model. That model we call as a mission model. That model gives to output, right? That model gives to output. By using this input and output, the two variables, we are giving the two variables data, and the model will be learning. This model, learning model, will be performing some learning algorithms. That learning algorithm gives some output. So we get the model itself is given to the labeled data. Labeled data or training data. Labeled data or training data. So means we are giving the input and output to the model to learn learning algorithms. So we are giving model, whatever the model we are preparing, that model to follow in the machine learning algorithms, and it will generate the output based on the label. Suppose we have to predict the output of coming weather report, whether tomorrow based on the attributes. Suppose we are calculating the outlook, sunny, rainy. By calculating these attributes, whether we can go for predict the particular label, whether tomorrow is sunny or overcast or rainy. By giving that particular label wise, we following this particular supervised learning means we are giving a training on the particular input and perform some task on the particular algorithm, and it will use to output on based on the labeled wise. Or else we can define the class yes or no prediction, yes or no, like that we can define by using this learning model. Unsupervised means, so whatever we are giving the particular, only input data, we don't know whatever the input data we are giving, that model will learn with the unlabeled data we have. Unlabeled data we have, that unlabeled data will be perform some learning algorithm, then it will give to prediction output, either it is output on unlabeled, whatever the classification data is given. Means, suppose I am teaching machine learning algorithm, so similarity of whatever the inputs I am given, that similarity output will be given to the output, right? Similarity here we measure, then means unsupervised similarity. Similarity base, it is a class base. Classes base, it is gives to supervised. Similarity base will give to unsupervised data will be present. Now another model learning is also there. Reinforcement model. So in the reinforcement model are semi-supervised. Another one is semi-supervised model. It is a combination of semi-supervised model, nothing but it is a combination of supervised and unsupervised. It is a combination of supervised and unsupervised. So before going to semi-supervised, it is a combination of supervised and unsupervised. Reinforcement learning. Reinforcement learning. This is the third one, is the fourth one. First one is supervised, we already discussed. Second one is unsupervised. This also we already discussed. So reinforcement means, suppose we are giving any activity or any learning programming, based on that particular activity or learning programming, it will give us a reward or award. So based on the actions, it will be rewarded or awarded will be comes on the particular learning methodology. That we call as a reinforcement learning. Example is, suppose we have to perform some any activity based on the robot or fraud detection based on that. So we are easy to identify that particular way of learning method, it will be rewarded. It is not easy to identify, that will be punished. On time, in time, it is going or not by using the particular agent wise. Agent based was, we can go for reinforcement learning. Right? Here, semi-supervisor learning nothing but, it is a combination of supervisor and supervisor. Supervisor with following the trainer, training data set, and supervisor with following the similarity pressure based was. So it is a combination of supervisor and supervisor. We are giving the inputs only with training data based on the inputs. Some data is given to input, some data is not given to unlabeled data we are giving. Based on that combination, we have to classify our semi-supervisor learning. So this is the way we can define our machine learning techniques. Coming to this, how the classification will be done. In supervisor has how many types, unsupervisor has how many types, how we can define, what are the applications we have, see nowadays. So machine learning algorithms, nowadays, so many applications are there. For example, prediction, weather report forecasting wise, and fraud detection, for credit card fraud detection, for it's also very very important in the particular machine learning algorithms implemented. And health domain, so predict the particular disease, any disease. The health domain also very very important to predict the what is the disease it has, how much percentage it is accurately defined particular way of disease. We can use a machine learning algorithms, we can easy to identify. And banking sectors also, we can predict the what is the weather, this particular profile has a credit balance is maintained or not, whether we sanction the loan or not. Based on that, we can use the prediction algorithms also. And next one is the reinforcement based on the particular way, whether the recommendation systems we have. So we had product on the e-commerce websites, so we got more recommendations with the particular way of product wise. That also we can go for the prediction on the particular reinforcement learning also. So these are the main applications to have in a machine learning then. So particularly we can just go through classification and unsupervised, what are the algorithms we have, we will discuss one by one. So classifications are, so basically they have classifications algorithms. Classification learning algorithms. So what is the classification? It is a part of a supervisor learning method. So by applying the model, we are giving the two types of input, input and another output. The model will be learned on the particular, based on the label wise, whether that model is belongs to that particular class or yes or no prediction will be done on the particular classification learn. So based on the, this learning, the first one is k nearest neighbor, second one is random forest, third one is support vector machine, fourth one is decision tree. Like that we can go for one by one. What is the classification algorithms is going on to particular learning methods, how we can go for these different types of classification we'll do. Suppose I'm going to, in general way, we have to purchase any new building. So we have to purchase any new building, what is the price of that particular way, variation on the particular location wise, how it is varied from the location wise. Suppose in a particular area, for a particular area house prices will be decreases, in the other particular area house prices will be increases. How we can make a classification on particular, which variable is very important to measure this particular attribute, how it is varied on a particular way of one variable, it is depending on the another variable. So whenever we are going to machine learning, we have to depending on the variable, how it is based on the variable wise, how it is variation will become on the particular our learning algorithm models. So that is the only important on the particular classification method. In that we can go for what are the algorithms we have. K nearest about forest, for random forest and decision tree and support vector machine, we see one by one.